Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello everyone, welcome to second PU statistics online classes. In the previous class we had discussed about important problem of binomial expansion method. In this class we are going to discuss similar type of problem, that is problem number 5. So from the following data, estimate probable life expectancy of an average Indian for the year 1980 and 2010, and here given informations are birth years are given and life expectancies are given. See here, birth years are independent variable and life expectancy are that is dependent variable, and we know that independent variable is denoted by X. So here X be the birth years, and dependent variable is denoted by Y. So here Y be the life expectancy, and therefore, so if it is Y observation, in the sense here the first observation is Y naught. So here Y naught is 68.2 and Y1 is 69.7 and Y2 is 70.8 and Y3 is missing value and Y4 is 75.4 and Y5 is 77 and Y6 is missing value. So these are the given information. So therefore, to apply binomial expansion to this problem, there are some procedures are there. In that first one, we need to find the known number of dependent variables. See, independent variable, so these two values are unknown, and here known number of observations are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So here 5 observations are known. Therefore, independent variable, known number of observations are 5. Therefore, I will write n is equal to 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 5 observations are known observations. After that, I will write, there are 2 missing values are there. Therefore, I will write delta naught to the power n is equal to 0 and delta naught 1 to the power n is equal to 0. First I will consider this one, that is delta naught to the power n is equal to 0, and see here n is 5, therefore in the place of n I will write 5 is equal to 0, and here delta naught to the power n, in the sense that we can write y minus 1 to the power n is equal to 0. So here what is n? N is nothing but 5, that we can write y minus 1 to the power 5 is equal to 0. Now I will expand this left hand side using binomial expansion method. So that is, so before that I will write Pascal's triangle. So to expansion of binomial we need Pascal's triangle. So Pascal's triangle is like this. So for n is equal to 0 the coefficient is 1, and if n is equal to 1 the coefficient is 1 and 1. If n is equal to 2, the coefficient is 1 plus 1 is 2. That I will write in middle of this 1, 1, 1. Again, I will add 1, 1. And see here, this is for if n is equal to 2. And if n is equal to 3, the coefficients are like this. So, 1 plus 2 is 3. Then 2 plus 1 is 3. Again, we need to add 1 and 1. So, if n is equal to 4, the coefficient is like this. 1 plus 3 is 4, 3 plus 3 is 6, 3 plus 1 is 4. Again we need to write like this 1 and 1. And see here n is equal to 5, so we need to write one more term is like this. So if n is equal to 5, the coefficient is like this. So 1 plus 4 is 5, 4 plus 6 is 10, so 6 plus 4 is 10. 4 plus 1 is 5. Again we need to add 1 and 1. See here n is equal to 5. Therefore we need to take this coefficient. So using this coefficient we can write this binomial expansion method, binomial expansion for this y minus 1 to the power 5. So So that is, see here the power is 5, that we can write. So I will, for this, for that first I will write like this. So here the power is 5, that is y5, y4, y3, y2, y1, y0 is equal to 0. And next I will multiply signs to this equation. The first is plus, so plus no need to write because it is first observation. Next is minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, and minus. Then coefficient, the first term is 1. So 1 into y5 is y5, 5 into y4 is 5y4, 10 into y3 is 10y3, then 10 into y2 is 10y2, 5 into y1 is 5y1, the last one is 1. So 1 into y0 is y0 only, and I will call it as equation number 1. See, and here y0, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6 observations are there. These are y observations. So now I will substitute this y observation in this equation. So here what is y5? y5 is 77. So in the place of y5, I will write 77 minus 5 into what is y4? y4 is 75.4. So into 75.4 plus 10 into what is y3? y3 is unknown value. Therefore, here I will write y3 as it is minus 10 into y2. So here y2 is 70.8 plus 5 into y1. So 5 is, I will write as it is 5 because here 5 is coefficient. What is y1? y1 is 69.7 minus what is y0? y0 is 68.2. And this is equal to 0. Okay, let me cross check. See here y5 is 77. Then minus as it is 5 into what is y4? y4 is 75.4. Then plus 10 into y3. Because here y3 is missing value. Then minus 10 into y2. y2 is 70.8. Then plus 5 into y1. y1 is 69.7. Yeah, next last is minus y0. y0 is 68.2. So that is equal to right hand side. Right hand side is 0. Okay, next. So here it is single value, that is I will write as it is. 77 minus 5 into 75.4. 5 into 75.4. That is 377. Plus, so here y3 is unknown. Therefore, I will write as it is. Minus 10 into 70.8, that is 708, plus 5 into 69.7, that is 348.5, yeah, minus 68.2 is equal to 0. And see, here this 73 is unknown value. Therefore, I will leave this value with the sign. And next remaining value, I will simplify like this. That is, first one is 77. Next, minus 377. Next, minus 708. Plus 348.5. Next, minus 68.2. That is minus 727.7. So this is plus 10y, that I will write as it is. And here I got, after simplification, that is minus 727.7. And this is equal to right hand side, that is 0. And see here, this is negative term. Therefore, I will bring this negative term right hand side. That is 10y3 is equal to 727.7. So here we need to find y3 value. Therefore, y3 is equal to 727.7 divided by 10 is 72.77. So here probable life expectancy in the year for the year 1980 is 72.77. 77. So here missing value Y3 is 72.77, or probable life expectancy for the year 1980 is 72.77 years. Okay, next. So here we got one missing value, that is Y3. Here one more missing value is it there, that is Y6. So how to find out this Y6? Using one more equation. So this is first equation, we need second equation. So how to write second equation? Second equation can be obtained by increasing the suffix of each term of y by 1 and keeping the equation coefficient and signs same. So see, so first to get second equation, we need to increase suffix of each term of y by 1 and keeping this sign and coefficient constant. So how to increase this suffix? So first I will increase this suffix. First one is so y5. So y5 we can write. So if I increase by 1, we can write y6. Next here it is y4. So if 4 is increased by 1 in the sense, that is y5. And here it is y3. So y3 is increased by 1, that is y4. Next y2. So that is increased by 1 in the sense, we can write y3, and this y1 we can write y2, and the last one is y0. y0 we can, so is this 0 increased by 1 in the sense, we can write y1 and this is equal to 0. This is right hand side, and I will call it as equation number 2. This is second equation, this is first equation. And okay, this is all about the increasing suffix of the each terms of y by 1. And next one more procedure is there, that is and keeping the coefficient and signs same. So here signs and coefficients are there, that here kept constant. So how to write this? First I will put signs, this plus, minus, plus, minus, plus and minus. And coefficients is there here, that is 1 into y6 only. So next 5 into y5, that is y5. Next 10 into y4, that is 10y4, 10 into y3, that is 10y3, 5 into y2, that is 5y2, and here 1 into y1, that is 1y1 only, that is equal to 0. And let me check this. See, here suffixes are increased by 1, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1 and 0, and see the signs are remain constant, 0, sorry, plus, here it is minus, plus, minus, plus and minus. And let me check the coefficients. For this is 1, and here it is 5, here it is 10, here it is 10, here it is 5 and here it is 1. Okay, this is equation number 2. And see here, y6 value is, y6 is unknown value. Therefore, I will write y6 as it is minus 5 into y5. So 5 is coefficient, and what is y5? y5 is 77. Then plus 10 into y4. So here y4 is 75.4. So in the place of y4 I will write 75.4. next minus 10 into y3. So this is y3, 10 into y3. See here y3 we already calculated. So here y3 value is 72.77 plus 5 into, what is y2 here? y2 is 70.8. next minus, what is y1? y1 is 69.7, and this is equal to 0. So see the signs. So minus, minus, plus, minus, plus and minus. Okay, now see here y6 is unknown value. Therefore I will write y6 as it is minus 5 into 77, that is 385, plus 10 into 75.4, that is 754, minus 10 into 72.77, that is 727.7, plus 5 into 70.8, that is 354 minus 69.7 and is equal to 0. See here, y6 is unknown value, therefore I will write y6 as it is, and remaining terms I will simplify. See the first term, that is minus 385 plus 754, next minus 727.7 plus 354, next minus 69.7. So the total is minus 74.4. So y6 minus, after simplification I got minus 74.4. And see here, the right hand side is, this is equal to 0. And see here, this is minus 74.4 is, that is negative term. Therefore, I will bring this right hand side. Now it will become positive value, that is 74.4. So here the missing value, that is y6, is 74.4, that is probable of probable of life expectancy in the year 2010 is the 74.4. therefore the conclusion is like this, that is probable of life expectancy for the year, first one is 1980 is 72.77 year. Next is second missing value, that is probable of life expectancy for the year 2010 is, right, no, the year 2010 is 74.4 year. Okay, these are the important problems of binomial expansion method. Thank you for watching this video.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.